And what we're going to cover today is new rider tips and advice. New rider tips and advice for those new riders. Now, for the purpose of this video, we're not talking about young riders. We're talking about new riders, no matter what the age is, or if you've been off the bike for quite some time, some tip to get you back in the game. And just to let you know, you are with Boots and Jeans Riders. I am Rich.
And I'm Cake.
And we're going to just go jump right into this subject right now. Well, one of the reasons we want to do it also because Chopper Fett actually done one. And, you know, everybody do new rider tips and advice. But he wanted to keep it going. So we decided to do ours today.
Right.
And we're going to start with the first one. You going to start with one, Cake?
Yeah, I can start with one.
Go ahead.
It's to take the basic rider's course. That's
yes.
The best advice that I can give somebody that's starting out new or wanting to learn how to ride a motorcycle.
Right.
To take that basic rider course, you will learn a whole lot with them because they are professionals,
yes,
instructors, and they will go by the book.
Right.
So they won't miss anything in teaching you the safety of riding motorcycles. Now,
exactly.
Someone else can teach you how to ride, that's fine. But
one lane to your left, open.
Coming over.
Copy that.
But, you know, coming from the professionals.
Right.
And you know, so
and that,
the basic rider's course.
And with that in mind, once you have taken that course, the next thing that we can actually advise you is to practice and start practicing immediately. Of course, once you have your bike, and we'll talk about the bikes in a minute. So practice immediately, and the thing that you should be practicing is the things that you learn.
You learn in the basic rider's course.
Exactly. Now, if you don't have a bike already, I would say the next thing for a new rider is when shopping for a bike. What kind of bike would you get, Cake?
Get the bike that fits you. No, you want to go and get a big old bike. If that's the bike that you want, then just make sure it fits you.
Right.
You know, we have a video on how I started off riding my bike when I first started. They wanted
yeah.
me to get a little bike, like I learned on in the class. But once I sat on the bike and I feel that this is going to be my bike, so I want to get what I want.
Yes.
And you know, and the main thing for me was to make sure my feet was flat on the ground when I stopped my bike.
Yes, and to add to that, also they also, a lot of people can tell you, don't get this bike, don't get that bike. What's a good beginner bike? I say it is all with maturity, mindset, throttle control. You can ride any bike, but for a new
yeah.
rider, I would not advise you to go get a high power sports bike. But just make sure you ride a bike that you can control and a bike is not controlling you.
Right. But of course, all of that, you'll be able to control it with practice. Everything comes and
everything
refers
come with
right
practice.
Back to practice.
Exactly. You can't get enough of practice. Now, if you have no spot to practice in, one of the best things that we can tell you to do is ride your neighborhood.
Right.
Ride your neighborhood.
Ride the neighborhood because you know where your stop signs are. You know the time of day that the most people are going to be out in your neighborhood.
Yeah, you know all your traffic patterns.
You know what's going on in your neighborhood. So if it's less people out and children out, not riding their bikes, and you know, skating or whatever it is that they do in your neighborhood, you don't want you know the time. So, you know, get out there and learn and to turn your bike, make U-turns and right and left turns. Ride in your neighborhood. Get to know your bike by riding in your neighborhood.
Yeah, starting in traffic, stopping at stop signs, stoplight. Like Cake said, you know what the traffic patterns are with the less traffic. So ride your neighborhood and do that every single day. Even when you're coming from work and you're tired and everything, get you a little rest, then go out and ride your neighborhood.
Right.
And with that in mind, you know, you don't take the safety course. It's gear. Have your safety gear on. I do not care what any other riders say, and I'm not going to tell what riders to wear and I'm not going to be a safety gear police and a helmet police and a glove police, but you as a new rider, the likelihood of you going down or dropping your bike is extremely high compared to a more experienced rider. So go wear the safety gear. Cake and I are AGAT, all the gear, all the time, 100% of the time. You know, and I don't want to get too much on that because I want to cover something that I've been thinking about for quite some time. And one of the main reasons we're doing this also is because we have some new riders that just recently got their endorsement.
Yeah.
Less than 6 months, you would say, Cake?
I'll say that, yeah.
Coming up around probably about 6 months. And we want to put this out for them also if they're watching this video and they know who they are. Another piece of advice I want to bring up, Cake, is, you know, you got the class, you're doing everything, you listen to a lot of people, and you got your bike, and you're so excited to go on it, you got to do your inspections. Keep your inspections up. You got to inspect that bike because, you know, this is a fun sport, but it can be very, very dangerous also. And what I mean by bike inspection, T-clocks.
T-clocks.
Yes.
Yeah, you guys, you know what T-clocks are, right?
Right.
Tires, controls, lights, oil, and kickstand, your side stand.
Exactly. I'll try to remember the exact acronym for it. Good thing you remembered it. Yeah, do your T-clocks. Go on, take that one, okay?
Yeah, especially those tires, because that's the meat of the bike right there, the tires. They're on the ground. Let me just say this. When you're checking your tires, make sure you rotate your tire. Because I made the mistake at one time of just looking at my tire, and I didn't put it on the center stand, and I didn't rotate my tires. So as we're riding, somebody looked and said, oh, we won't be riding too much longer.
Somebody? No, you know Willie told you about
because
that. Y'all know the Willie D. She busted Karen with a ball tire.
Yeah, he did. That wasn't good, you know. But
it turned somewhere else. I don't want to stay riding into the sun.
Okay, well, turn here.
Hey, Antioch Police Department. So mess with their motor unit.
They don't want none of us. And I had to sit out a day because I needed to get a tire on my bike. And
right.
The type of riding we were going to do, that wasn't good, you know. So put that bike on the center stand. If you don't have a center stand, make sure you move your bike forward and then go back and check them tires and make sure that you have no balls, no gouges, no threads showing on your bike.
Right.
So that's all I got to say about the tires. Make sure that the tires are done. And as you're checking them, make sure you look at the brake pads and see how much meat you have on them brakes.
Right.
Know, I'm not going to go into further details, but you know what the T-clocks are, you know, the lights. Check and make sure that those lights are working. So your blinker, turn it on. Walk to the back of your bike and make sure your blinkers are working. Make sure your brakes are working. You know, it's an easy way that you can check your front brakes to make sure that they're working, you know, and you know, tire string on that front brake. Like, remember, when we were on the bike, I told you I was going to show you how to check your brake lights. When you're by yourself, get you a string long enough, put it on your brake, your handbrake. Just walk around to the back of your bike, pull it, and there you can see your lights, your brakes light working. Now I'm gonna show you how to do it when you're by yourself and you need to check your rear brakes. I'm gonna close the garage. Now that I have the garage door closed, I put my bike as close to the garage door as possible so I can see when my brake lights are coming on. And I press my rear brake and it shows. See the reflection? I know that all my brake lights are in working condition. And that's how you do it when you're by yourself. If you have somebody, you just have them stand back there and say, oh yeah, okay, cool. They're all in working condition. And that's all that I have that I wanted to show you how to use it. Remember, just get you a string, tie a loop, put it on your handbrake, make it long enough, pull it back, come to the back, and check your brake light.
One thing I want to mention is, with new riders, we have a video on this, what I'm about to mention, so make sure you check out the video, is the fear of getting on the freeway. with new riders, you know, like in a video, Cake mentioned it, get in on one on-ramp and get off the next one. And we don't want to stay on that too long because they can watch that video, and I'll plug that video in it also to help new riders who want to get on the freeway. Hey, bicyclists. Something else I can think of. Well, most importantly, the most important thing with new riders is to relax and have fun. The more tense you're on a bike, the more you're not going to want to do it daily. You're not going to want to go in the parking lot and practice. Just relax. Have fun. The bike can go straight all by its own. When you start practicing things in a parking lot, then you start practicing moving over to your left, Kate. I mean, your right. There's a rider coming out. We'll let it pass us.
I see. Copy that.
Yeah, and like this, new riders, it's a good example. Somebody coming up from the rear, don't get scared. Pull over to the right, wave them through. Let them pass you. And we're just doing that because we're riding slow and we're doing this video. And his bike was coming up pretty quick and he was kind of stuck behind Kick and I. So we just moved over to the right and let him pass. I don't know the experience of that bike. He might be new, he might be a very experienced guy. But just to have safety and fun in mind, we'll let him pass.
Right.
But relax. Anything else you want to add to this video, Kick?
No. I think that'll be about it.
Yeah, but I think the most important of all the things we get is the first one, is to take that basic
rider course. Take that course.
Anyway, if you're out riding, remember, ride long, ride hard, ride strong, but most importantly,
ride safe.
From Boots and Jeans Riders, I'm Rich.
We're going to take it right up here.
Copy that.
And I'm Cake.
And we out.
Peace.